You can even have my set of bunny ears.
I'm good. You keep it. Put it on.
I was trying to. Okay. Awesome. Guys, love it. You guys can go die. Oh my goodness.
They're really excited. They're about to die Easter eggs with.
Yeah,
Anna,
they're pretty pumped up.
So.
Awesome.
Okay, bye, girls, and bye, Henry.
Welcome, guys. We have a. We have a pretty rocking afternoon for you. I hope you're. I hope you can feel it. I hope you're ready. Tell you what I want to start out with today. First of all, everybody, pour a little wine in your glass.
I don't know which one.
Yeah. Oh.
We're starting though with what are we starting with?
We're going to start with the Farmhouse Mourvèdre.
Yes.
So pour a little wine in a glass. Get a little loose.
We're surprising you with our lineup. We thought we were going to start with Pétillant. I bet.
Yeah, but get some wine in your glass. But after you get the wine in your glass, number one, okay. I want you to give your watching partners a big hug.
Done.
Maybe even a little makeout.
Okay.
Tell them how much you love them. Give them a squeeze. Hold on. Dylan, come over here. Kelsey, come on. Oh, we had a Zen moment before we started. Come on, Cole.
Bring it in. It's Easter.
We're our crew. It's our Easter. Give us a squeeze. Let everybody around you know how much we appreciate you.
Skip on the kiss, though.
I'm not hugging anymore. I'm just making out. So that's my new deal. It's post-COVID now, so I'm just making out. So anyways, welcome. I don't know about you guys. I mean, like, I feel great about wearing bunny ears right now. But no big deal. It's been a hell of a two months. I mean, like, yeah, a hell of a year. But I just feel like, man, the past month has been stressful.
Yeah.
And I usually don't
relax.
Yeah, me too. We've got a lot of things going on at the winery. a lot of things going on around the vineyard. Usually this is this is a really exciting time. We've got lots of fun stuff going on, and we've been busier than we ever have been. We're fully booked pretty much every weekend, and it's so great. I hope you guys know, like, right outside, our tasting room is rocking. It's beautiful and it's amazing. I just saw, like, there's probably a herd of like 20 kids out there, and they all have bubble wands and they are all blowing bubbles like crazy. And I asked one of our team members who's working on the pavilion, I was like, is there like a birthday party? I'm like, no, it's just all the kids just started hanging out and they're like a bubble train.
They've made new friends with their bubbles.
Yeah, pretty awesome. Thank
y'all. If as you're joining us, put in the comments where you're joining us from. If this is the first time you joined us for a virtual tasting, put some little asterisks in front of your comments so we can welcome you rightly.
Yeah. Who do we got today, by the way? From College Station, Cynthia Calmly, what's up? Jim Fritz, good to see you, buddy.
Nancy's got some blueberries in her bowl.
Sarah Waterwell, what's up, Sarah? Welcome. Hadn't seen you in a while. Kurt, good to see you.
Reed and Brian, we've got Alan and Rochelle. She likes our bunny ears. Thank you. It's been a long time since I've worn a headband. We'll see how long it lasts.
I mean, I used to wear headbands a lot, and so it's no big deal.
So, yeah, you're used to it.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Welcome, Jerry and Ron. Got Nancy. Happy Easter to you too. Katie's from Houston. Got Michelle, also likes our bunny ears. Awesome. We got so many dancing
Amanda.
Bunnies. Rhett, thank you for joining us.
We got lots of fun people.
Lots of fun.
Man, this has been. We were in a wedding last weekend. We were in Houston. We were in and out. It was great to be cruising again and traveling a little bit. We had an amazing time in H-Town. A little too amazing, I think. We had one of our roommates getting married.
Yeah, we saw old college friends and made the mistake of acting like we were in college again for a few hours.
Yeah.
It was awesome. So much fun.
You know, also last week, and a little update, we had a the grape compromise bill. I got to testify on the Senate floor, which is pretty awesome, and got a chance to testify in the House committee as well. And I think that we finally got our Texas wine bill on in a good place. So I think what's going to happen is, if you can look at this Texas, this Mourvèdre right here. So if it says Farmhouse Vineyards, or if it says a vineyard name or an ABA like Texas High Plains, this bill would ensure that 100% of the wine that's in this bottle is from Texas. And so this is a little bit of a compromise from the bill that we tried to push last session, which was, if it said Texas at all, it actually had to be 100% from Texas. Honestly, I think some of the, probably some of the winery owners were, they're ready to shut us up because we had been really broadcasting this pretty widely. And they came to the table this year, which is awesome. I really appreciate the sense of compromise. And so we put together a bill that really works for some of the larger wineries that want the option to bring in finished wine from out of state or out of country and put it in a bottle and still label it Texas. They can still put 25%, which is a bummer to me, but that's okay.
It's progress.
We wanted our fans to know that any wine from Texas that had a vineyard name on it, an AVA, which is like Texas Hill Country or Texas High Plains, or a county designation, that you will know that it's 100% Texas grown, and then that's backed by the TABC. So anyways, lots of good news there. This has been really an 8-year battle for me. Really been working hard on this for quite a long time. So I got to give a shout out to Matthew Bentley, our lobbyist, and there's so many folks at the Capitol that have been believing this for a long time.
And so many people in the industry. There's so many people.
There's so many fans too. Yeah. I know that. Yeah, we really appreciate it. It's been a wild ride, and it's totally not over yet. I mean, this bill could still not get passed, even though it's got industry-wide support.
Yeah.
So
you just never know.
Yeah.
Well, you guys notice we are starting with a red wine, mm-hmm. not our norm. While we do have a rosé in the lineup, Pet Nat is on the lineup. We're not opening it first. We're opening it last. If it's not already there, please go put it in your fridge. If it's not cool at all, go ahead and stick it in your freezer for a little bit. Store it upright.
This is what we got going on right here.
We got ours in an ice bucket.
Ice bucket, yeah, about halfway submerged. We'd like it a little bit more submerged, but I think it's going to be just fine. Either way,
it's really pretty. It's really cold. We're in the barrel room. It's chilly in here also. So
I'm going to open it and point it at Catherine. So
no, you're not going to point it at me because I'm going to be doing something else. We'll get there in a minute.
I saw an Instagram video. You know how you can like hit somebody's beer?
Yes.
I saw the best one ever.
Was it with Pet Nat?
No. A girl came up to a guy at a bar and like hit his beer. And he just smiles right at her and goes like this. And it sprayed all in her face. I thought, I'm going to be totally prepared.
This is what Chris watches on Instagram.
I waste some time on Instagram.
Yeah. When he should be just turning his light off, going to bed. This is what he's doing.
That's right.
Watching bar videos on Instagram.
Hey, come on now.
All right. Oh, man. Okay. So we had some grand prize winners going into this. In the pack, we had some eggs. We had some little like colorful eggs. And then we had the golden eggs. I think they were gold. Were they gold eggs, Kelsey? I can't remember now what it was.
It's like a big golden egg.
Big, yeah. Giant golden egg. It was like a placemat. Yeah. But anyway, it was flat.
Congrats to the two winners.
Yeah. They won a library tasting for four people and a private lunch with Chris and I, and a tour also. So it's Victor Stonebrook. And Victor, I already saw you guys are watching with us today. Congratulations. And Arthur Stafford, I haven't noticed your name in here yet, but hopefully you're watching with us too. We can't wait to see you all.
I think we have one of those lunches scheduled already.
Yes, I believe it's Victor's already reached out.
Victor,
and on the books.
Get your game face on because we're going to have a heck of a lunch. We're going to have a really good time. So thank you for all who participated in that too. It was a pretty fun little couple weeks there.
Yeah, but everyone's a winner because they got some wine in their cup.
That's right. That's right. So, okay, again, put that Pet Nat in the fridge upright or on some ice because we're going to open up last because we've got some celebrating to do.
Yeah.
We wanted to finish this tasting with a little bit of a bang. So.
If you're wondering what we are going to be starting with because you're anxious to start tasting, we're starting with the Farmhouse Mourvèdre. That's mm-hmm. what Chris and I already have a little in our glass. We haven't talked about it yet. But that's what we're going to be starting with if you want to go ahead and pour yourself.
Yeah, let's jump right into it.
Yeah, you ready to talk?
Yeah.
All right.
So the Farmhouse Mourvèdre. These guys, and Kelsey, I'm sorry I jumped ahead a little bit. But
well, all we forgot to say was that we congratulated last time's winners. There will be winners today. So stay tuned.
Yeah, there's going to be winners.
There's more winners to come.
And we've got a getaway giveaway at the end of this today too, which I'm pretty excited about. Okay, so Farmhouse Mourvèdre. This is grown by some really cool cats. There's two guys and their wives. So Anthony and Nick are predominantly on the farming side. They farm cotton, watermelon, peanuts, like you name it. They farm quite a bunch of different things. And they are very ahead of the curve on the farming side. They also have Farmhouse Winery. They actually have a tasting room in Brownfield, Texas, in Terry County, close to one of their vineyards. And they also have a tasting room in Johnson City. Really great folks. Tracy, the wife of Anthony, and then Katie Jane. Katie Jane used to be the director of the Texas Hill Country Wineries Association. She's been a good friend for a long time. Anyways, very good people. We love investing in their vineyard. And this wine, 2017, which was one hell of a vintage, probably one of the best vintages in my lifetime. This is really just an incredible vintage. We had a very long growing season and were able to ripen. Coincidentally, we were able to make a lot higher alcohol wines, which stylistically isn't always in line with what William Chris Vineyards does. That being said, it was the vintage to do it, and it really made some incredible wines. This wine is drinking absolutely stunning right now. Mm-hmm. That kind of mocha, espresso, caramel,
I feel like you've said a few times this is your favorite Mourvèdre from that vintage.
It is definitely up there.
Up there in the top.
Yeah,
it's just so different than our others, to me. Wouldn't you think?
Mm-hmm. And this is on the far west side of Terry County. So there's definitely an influence of a lot of sand sage out there. You get a little bit sandier soil than you do in southern Terry County. But I'm just so blessed. And we've been working with this vineyard for some years now. This is probably third or fourth vintage. And I could not be happier with how this is drinking now. I mean, this is a four-year-old wine, and it's stunning.
Gorgeous. And delicious.
Yeah, but it's also... just FYI, 15.4% alcohol. So if you're trying to make something happen after dinner, after your tasting, this might be the bullet you want to put in your
ticket,
gun,
huh?
If you know what I mean.
Oh my God. You're so weird.
Or
you're
you can
so
just wear
weird.
Bunny ears. I mean, I heard that always works.
Always.
Yeah. So
they're getting close to going off here.
Yeah, I might have to. Actually, I'm going to keep them on. I'm going to rock the bunny ears. I feel confident in there.
We've got all this space above our head in the screen, so might as well fill it up.
You know, so something that I've been learning or hearing about, we have like, I think there's five different California wineries opening up tasting rooms. Not wineries. They're not buying Texas grapes. They're just opening up tasting rooms in and around this area. And I got a little frustrated just thinking about it, because I got a couple of phone calls from different folks like about this week. And in the end, I was kind of frustrated because I'm like, man, I really don't like how our industry is going. And then I was thinking about all the wonderful folks that are just doing a fantastic job in Texas right now. One of which we actually just came from, Lewis Wines. And I don't know if you guys, there's our pro tip for the week. We just went to Lewis Wines. I don't know, Kelsey, did you get a picture that you can put up? Doug's wines were awesome. Doug Lewis and Duncan McNabb over there have been just making really good wine for a long time. Mm-hmm. And they're young and energetic and have been figuring it out. And their lineup of wines today was really incredible. That's the Farmhouse crew.
The Farmhouse crew.
I did have a picture that I sent you earlier, Kelsey, of Doug and us.
So good. We had a great tasting over at Lewis earlier.
Yeah, picked the rosés were killer.
Picked up our wine club release.
And I think our favorite of the day was the Grenache Mourvèdre over there. It was really,
so good.
Really spot on, really crushable.
Obviously, we are Mourvèdre.
Yeah.
Mourvèdre fans.
Mourvèdre fans for sure. But it got me thinking about like getting to know, like,
you want to splash more?
Yeah, thank you. I want all of you out there to like drink like you give a damn, you know? And when I say that,
know where it's coming from. No, and I mean, so you can go as far as your food too, but we're focusing on wine. You know where your wine's coming from.
Absolutely. And if we can just encourage people to have more intention in their in consuming products. I mean, like when you buy a bottle of wine from William Chris Wine Company, it means something to us. Like we are very much thankful for that money. Maybe in 10 years we'll be like able to put it in some sort of portfolio, but our portfolio is our people, you know, we're reinvesting in our company and our people and our team, providing things like health insurance. We're rolling out a 401k, like we're helping our growers, and we're farming more and helping our growers invest in innovation to make Texas agriculture better. And in the end, that's what I think community is all about. And I would just encourage all of our viewers out there to like think about where their money goes. And I'm probably preaching the choir with all you guys out there, but
spread the word.
Yeah, I feel compassion for people who just like don't even care where their food comes from and just mindlessly go, like a lemming where everybody tells them to go and, or just pop in and don't think about the effect of what your investment in product has. And, if we're trying to do some real good with this community and these transactions that happen. And ultimately, I want to do business with more people that care about that. And I think ultimately, if we can share that intuition and share that knowledge, because it matters where your food comes from, it matters where your wine comes from. And if we can encourage other people to think about that, you know, it goes across the board. I mean, like, think about if we could support more Texas farmers by buying Texas grown cotton instead of just generic cotton. I mean, we have that ability with wine, and I think that we should use it. And same thing with your beer. I mean, like, drink what's great, drink what's delicious.
Right. Drink what you like, but what you like can be so altered by the story behind it once you take the time to learn it.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of amazing.
Yeah. So drink like you care, and know your farmer, because I think those things really are at the core of what we do. And ultimately, I think that's what's going to continue to make the world a better place. So. All right. My soapbox, I'm done.
All right. All right. Let's get back on track with this wine. You guys, obviously, it's Easter weekend. If you keep forgetting, just look above our heads. It's Easter weekend. This food would go wonderfully with your honey baked ham.
Ooh.
Great Easter standard. Green beans, I don't know, almondine. What is that? I want to make that. I'm guessing it's green beans with almonds on top, maybe baked.
Yeah, no, what's the
I want to make this.
No, what's garnish. Yeah, it's the garnish, but then what's the it's like
hollandaise on it?
No, it's like a liqueur. Dang it. There's a word for it, and I'm missing it.
I don't know. We made all our green beans last night.
Bacon wrap prosciutto with this wine. Mm. Oh, my gosh. I wish we had. But we do have some delicious cheese and some salami.
Bacon wrap prosciutto. That must be a typo. That doesn't make sense. Prosciutto is a kind of bacon. Mm. Like wrap prosciutto in bacon.
Prosciutto wrapped.
Asparagus, maybe?
Asparagus, that's what it is.
But that's not supposed to be. Yeah. I was like, this must
way be to go, Kolb. Way to mess that one up.
We want bacon wrapped in bacon.
Okay. Also, guys,
we almost just were like, yeah, bacon wrap prosciutto.
Mm-hmm. Good catch. Also, guys, let us know what you're doing. We want to hear about
what are you doing this weekend. What are you celebrating? Who are you celebrating with?
My
what
sister.
What are you drinking?
My sister is in town. That was her, our nephew,
mm-hmm.
Henry. He's in from Detroit. They are moving to the Hill Country.
Yay!
Thank goodness. He was a Delta pilot, and now he is
not Henry, his dad.
Yeah. And now he is a FedEx pilot, so they're able to move from Detroit. If anybody has a house for sale that's not crazy expensive, please let us know, because
yeah, they're looking on the market right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm trying to get them close. So
Pretty exciting. But anyway, we're looking forward to a great Easter weekend with them. Chris's parents are in town. My mom and stepdad are going to come over for a big meal tomorrow.
Yep.
So all in the family. It's gonna be awesome.
We just bought a bunch of chickens.
Yes.
That were raised at Lewis Wines. Julia Poplowski, and that's Doug's girlfriend, one of the owners of Lewis Wines. She's been raising chickens for months, and then she used to work at Daidue, and so she's slaughtering the chickens.
She's like a butcher, mm-hmm. which is the coolest thing ever, to actually be able to butcher something.
And they raised them all in the vineyards, and they raised sheep as well.
Mom, you're watching. Mom, my mom doesn't like lamb. Chris and I love eating lamb, but my mom does not like lamb. So don't worry, Mom. We're having chicken. You can rest.
We're also
easy.
Having lamb tomorrow, Jane. I hope you know.
Oh, we're still having lamb too.
Yeah,
never mind.
Yeah,
you
but we're gonna do
chicken
too.
Mom.
Yeah. So anyway, okay. Are we doing another no dump Saturday?
Well, we don't even have a dump bucket, so the choice is already made.
Ching ching.
But I have two glasses, so I don't have to down this. I can save it.
Okay, let's keep on going.
What's up next?
Let's go into the Gilliam Gap Mourvèdre, or Malbec. Yeah. So, a couple of things. While we're going into this, I want to talk about what the freeze damage did. So, Kels, could you bring up some of those pictures that we have? Oh, my gosh.
While she's bringing it up, it looks like a lot of people are celebrating a few birthdays. Everyone's with family. Oh, Brianna is celebrating being vaccinated. Definitely something to celebrate.
Awesome.
That's so
congratulations.
Awesome. Talk about a load off. Man.
Wrapping a pig.
Oh, they're all talking about bacon wrapped in bacon. Wrapping a pig and more pig. Oh, man. Anyway, Looks like everyone's got a good weekend coming.
FYI, too, we are closed tomorrow.
Yes, completely closed. So all of our staff, all of our team can be with whoever they want to be with and do whatever they want to do for the day. We don't close very many days of the year, but this is one.
Christmas and Super Bowl Sunday. Actually, we closed on Thanksgiving.
We didn't close Super Bowl Sunday this year.
Really?
Nope.
Okay, so
Chris is coming up to the screen.
Yeah, so can you blow it up a little bit, Kels?
For us, they have it pretty big, but we don't have it very big.
So I wanted to show everybody, this is kind of like a good example of what's going on right now. So this is probably one of our worst damaged blocks.
It still looks pretty good.
So you can see the buds. There's some buds that have come out, and they do have flowers on them, right? And that flower is fruit, which is good. But then you see a couple of buds that are either slower to pop or not popping at all over on the right. You know, those canes that are coming out. So each one of those, I don't know, if I raise the cursor, can they see that or no?
No.
Okay. So let's go to
if you want to make it bigger, baby.
Here. Yeah.
I don't know how to tap
you
it.
You can't.
She's got an Apple computer. I don't even know how to work it.
That's okay. It's okay. Don't worry about it. So you can see on the vine on the right has like shoots that are coming out. You can see this kind of lumpy things on the top that are the flowers. That's what's going to be pollinated because grapes are self-pollinated. And then they will move into – oh, thank you. That's perfect. They will move into being grapes. Now, you can see on the right side – of this cane or of the vine, there's buds that are just barely popping now. Those are probably secondary buds or, excuse me, or tertiary buds. So that, excuse me.
You want some of your water?
Yes, please. Thank you. So those buds are less fruitful than the primary buds. And those buds were probably hurt in the freeze. What's really cool is grapes are incredibly resilient. And while we may be looking at, say, 50 or 40% loss on the tenant, that's kind of one of the worst areas that we're affected by.
Is tenant like weaker or what's the deal?
It just seems like tenant around the hill country has been the one that kind of got dinged the most, which I think Tenant's a wonderful variety. And I mean, this is a 1 in 50 year freeze. So I don't think it's a reason to not plant Tenant.
Right.
But we'll see. Let's keep on farming it. You know, like not everything can be great every year, but I think that we'll end up with really high quality. We just might not have the quantity that we generally have. So we usually try to crop that at 4 or 5 tons to the acre. This will probably be like 2.5 to 3.5 tons to the acre. So,
Hey, Brianne asked, are we open Mother's Day? Yes,
absolutely.
We are. Come celebrate your mom with your mom. Mm-hmm. Cheers her and send her a picture, whatever works. We'll be here. Just make a reservation. Like Chris said in the very beginning, we're only reservation
on the weekends. Yeah, Friday, Saturday, for sure. So definitely make it out. Your mom will love you if you take her one, Chris wine. And if you can't be with your mother, you can also send her a pack.
Somebody in the comments said, so that's Bud Light for your buds, for the buds on the vine. Get it?
I got it.
Chris isn't laughing at your joke.
I got it.
I thought it was funny.
I got it. Sorry, I'm going to take my ears off now.
Oh, you couldn't hear the joke with him?
Oh, you're a little weird.
It's pretty cheesy.
You're eating cheese.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my goodness.
Okay, so we are drinking Gilliam Gap Malbec.
This one came with a recipe. You got it. If you purchased this pack, then you got the recipe in your email. I think it was Tuesday. I'd love to see in the comments if any of you made it. It was a rosemary roasted pork tenderloin, which I'm anything rosemary. I want. Like, I've made a rosemary bean soup yesterday. Mm-hmm. I love rosemary in a cocktail. Anything with rosemary sounds great. So did you make the recipe? And if so, how's it smelling? Did you already eat it? Is it in front of you right now?
Yeah, take a picture and send
it
to us.
In the oven?
That rosemary, we've made that pork loin recipe before, and it is Excellent.
Hopefully it's working for mm-hmm. you.
All right. So this is Gilliam Gap mm-hmm. Malbec. So this place is in Ropes, Texas, or Ropesville, Texas, rather. This is about 15, 20 minutes south of Lubbock. This block of grapes, can you pull up a picture of Dusty? So this block of grapes was planted for us about 9 years ago. This is Dusty Gilliam, who's an incredible grower. He's actually the vineyard manager for Buena Suerte Vineyards as well. But he and his family have 3.5 acres of Malbec right here on their family farm. And I had met him through his best friend, which is his best buddy is named Dusty Timmons, who's the vineyard manager for La Straw Vineyards and La Pradera Vineyards. These guys grew up together. Anyways, I had looked at the vineyard and really liked it. And this is, many years ago. And I asked Bill to come look at this vineyard. And when we were turning off the highway, he was like, he just seemed a little different. And then when we went up to the vineyard, which was down the road off the highway, he loved it. And Bill was just like, man, this guy's doing a great job. And this is definitely something we're interested in. Well, when we were leaving, I just saw Bill, like, just kind of, he was breathing a little heavier. And, ultimately, and I say Bill, the William part of William, Chris, I was like, hey man, you okay? And he's like, I grew up right over there. And it was about two sections over. And he was telling me how there was a little store that used to be at the end of the road, I mean, just like this little bitty shack. And he would walk through these fields when he was a kid to go get a Coke. And it just was awesome to see where Bill grew up. And like, it was literally his road. And it just kind of sealed the deal on, yes, this is the right vineyard for us. And Dusty Gilliam has done almost everything we've ever asked of him. He's done a great job. He has twin boys, and he and his wife farm this vineyard with their family. And it's very much a family operation. And I will say, like, we hardly have any blocks that are just 3 acres, especially as we've grown. But this guy, we will never let go of. I mean, he's just an incredible grower. And we've, since we started with him, helped him reinvest in hail netting and paying him. We're able to pay him more for his fruit than most people in the High Plains, because he's willing to reinvest some of those profits into sustainability, like having hail netting. We lost two different crops to hail and ropes. So,
man, the proof is in the pudding. This is delicious.
So we only make about 3.5 to 3.9 tons an acre. It's a small crop. Malbec is tricky in the High Plains because we always have to pick it. We have to pick it right on time. And this is 2018. Well, in 2017, we had a little dash of rain. And if you have a little dash of rain, boom, it can go south in a hurry because Malbec has very thin skins. And so what happens is if we're not careful, and you have a big crop on the vine and it takes a little bit longer to mature, to ripen, then we can get hosed by a rain that's coming in and affecting the quality of the grapes. So we want to make sure that we have the perfect crop load and not too deep of crop load on the block, because we want to, even that 1 or 2 days of getting it to the perfect amount of ripeness, we want to be able to pick perfect timing. And then because in 17 is when we did have that little rain, and it did, I think it didn't make the vintage as good as it could have been. But 18, we hit it on the nose. So delicious. Cheers to Dusty Gilliam. Yeah.
People are loving it in the comments. Someone says,
if you don't like this wine, I don't know. I mean, this is mm-hmm. seriously one of my favorite blocks in the High Plains. And, so a lot of this block goes into Hunter, which is Merlot Malbec. This year is going to be Merlot Malbec and a little Cabernet.
Tiny bit.
And it usually blends in fantastically well into Hunter. And then we take a small amount of that and just do this for our wine club. which I'm so happy we did. I'm just so stoked to even be able to taste this wine today. So
someone in the comments said they're having Hunter with their meal tomorrow.
Ooh, perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. Good call. Good call. All right. Well, let's keep on moving, guys.
Oh, now I've got two glasses of something in it.
Yeah, well, it's a no
dumps. The Malbec is pretty much gone. I'm ready.
Well,
I'm ready.
Something else.
Jennifer says, if you don't like this wine, please exit the video.
That's right. I'm with you. I'm with you. Hey, you know, something I did want to mention, like, you know, we had a, and I don't want to like bog everybody down with some heavy stuff, but.
Where are you going with this?
Well, last week we had, we were at a wedding and yes. I come back and Monday morning, we got a few negative reviews on Facebook. Which is like, as a business owner, like we really pay attention to reviews. You can't live and die by them because you'll totally get soul crushed. Most of our bad reviews end up being like, oh, screw these guys. We didn't know we needed reservations and, you know, stuff like that. But we had one of our best guys, Brent,
This is a terrible story.
Yeah, last weekend we had a limo show up. Anyways, long story short, or long story long, through the tasting, Brent reported that he noticed that a couple of the people were intoxicated and he didn't feel comfortable serving them anymore. And I will tell you, it's our job, right? It's a very tough thing as a business owner, and especially in the alcohol business. We hardly ever have this problem at William Chris. Not a whole lot of people are just, you know, slamming back $45 bottles of wine. However, it happens, you know, but we're not a bar, right? I mean,
It doesn't happen much, but we are responsible servers.
So anyways, a couple of the girls started making, Brent is Asian, and they started making some really, less than stellar comments about Asian people and, you know, which is so frustrating because you're trying to make sure that people are safe. And I will tell our team, like I have personally been cut off at a bar, maybe not a lot, but definitely more than five times. Right. Right.
And over his life,
over my life. Recently. Yeah, sure. Yeah. Not recently, but every single one of those times. And I hope that none of you have ever been cut off at a bar, but you know, well, I'm talking sure in college or whatever. And you know what? I never woke up in the morning and was like, I wasn't drunk. I shouldn't have been cut off. I was like, thank goodness they cut me off because, you know,
too much.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's our job. Right. And so anyways, it's super disheartening to get a negative review.
So we cut them off and then they were ugly.
Extremely ugly. And we try to do it with such like grace and be like, hey, I'm really sorry. We don't feel comfortable serving you anymore. And at William Chris, we always back our servers because ultimately the liability is on them. So anyways, it just made it for a really tough Monday when we're getting beat up online. But I will say thank you to all the people that jumped out there and supported us online. And I'm not asking for a positive review for us today. That's not what I'm doing. But I will say, out of your local businesses, if somebody does a great job, let them know and give them. If you want to help a business, besides just, you know, buying food from the restaurant or buying wine or buying beer or whatever it is, which is very much appreciated, something small that you can do that doesn't take any investment of money but just your time, like shoot them a positive review if you mean it. Like if you don't, then don't. Or you know, make sure that they know that that you're responding to an experience and shooting an email or making a phone call. Like every now and then we get a phone call or an email from a fan that says, "Hey, man, yes. I've been there 80 times and I absolutely loved every one of them, but this happened today." And I'm like, "Man, thank you so much."
We share that with the team.
We dig in awesome. And we find out. So, anyways, long story long.
Lots of great comments coming in. Gerald said, that ain't right. Stone cold sober. And we totally agree. It's just amazing what people, I think you get cut off and people get embarrassed. And then when people are embarrassed, ugly sides of them really come out. And mm-hmm. I think that's what brought it out, I guess. Anyway, terrible situation. Definitely never, never okay.
Mm-hmm.
But all, I mean, a lot of you are writing that you've had a tasting with Brent now.
Excellent. Yeah, Brent is one of our amazing, I mean, we have many amazing folks, but Brent is one of our top. We probably get more positive reviews over Brent than.
When my brother was in town for spring break, I had my first tasting with Brent. He did it for my brother and his girlfriend and my mom, his stepdad. We all sat through his tasting, and it was awesome.
Yep.
I love to do a tasting with staff members I haven't sat with before.
You know, that guy is trying to forward his wine education. So he works at a restaurant in Austin. He hasn't had a day off in 22 days.
Well, the day he was doing our tasting, he had worked past midnight at the restaurant because it was spring break and they were super crazy. I was like, you're such a hard worker.
The guy's an amazing worker, an amazing team member. So anyway, we can pass that. Moving on. Okay.
That was a long story. Yes, you can request, Brett. We cannot guarantee you're going to get
that's
your request, but you can request any server here, any ambassador that you have had before, loved the experience with, always request when you make your reservation.
And I'm not complaining, but that is the stuff that just like the ugly stuff as a business owner that you just have to deal with. It's like, man, we're trying to like do these great things and make all this amazing stuff happen. And then somebody's like, nope, I want to just hold you down a little bit. And this is what you're going to have to deal with on Monday. And you know what? That's our job. And I'm glad that I can take that instead of Brent, and Brent doesn't have to worry about that. Cause that's what we do as business owners. We say, hey, we would defend our people and watch out for our team. And we back our team. So yeah, you know what? You should have been cut off. I wasn't there, but I have 100% confidence with Brent every single time that he's going to make the right decision. Yep. So anyways, that does not mean you cannot come to William Chris and have a great time, because we like to have a great time, obviously.
Man, I love all these comments are calling out different tasting room ambassadors that they've had tastings with, that they loved. I just love it.
That is something too, that if you can, and again, I'm so not pandering for reviews for William Chris. Like, I appreciate them, great, but when you're reviewing a business, like if you can call out a name, you know, positively, then that goes so far. Like it really does go so far. So it
brightens everyone's day.
Yeah, for sure. So
okay, we've got to move on. Yeah. I didn't realize how long we've been going already.
We've been rattling.
Yeah,
another no dump Saturday.
I think the problem, if you can call it a problem, is that we've gone so long between our tastings. There for a while, it was every week.
Yeah,
so it was
just had a lot of stuff happening in our lives.
You were like our diary. You knew everything that happened. And now we're trying to cram a month's plus worth of information at you.
Yeah. Yeah. So La Pradera, Petit Verdot.
Yes. Moving on.
So this is Andy Timmons.
Oh, it still says on there, Kelsey, that we just opened the Malbec. Got to move on.
We just, La Pradera, Petit Verdot. This wine, 26 months in French and Eastern European barrels.
This is a big wine, y'all.
It's a big wine.
Get your snacks out for this one. I feel like this wine needs food.
Yeah.
Speaking of, the Easter pairing for
this is
deviled
delicious.
Eggs, which is...
Is that the one with bacon and jalapeno?
Maybe one of my favorite snack foods. I don't make it because I will make myself sick on them.
So... Deviled eggs,
so good.
I love, and Catherine makes the best ones, and she puts a little jalapeno in there.
No, that's Nikki.
That's Nikki, that's right.
That's our friend Nikki. So, she puts a little bit of bacon, a little bit of jalapeno in there.
Oh my gosh.
I make good ones, but I can't beat Nikki's.
So the downside is I'll eat like 18 of them. Oh my gosh.
And regret it.
Regret it. I get like
2 days.
Yeah, I'm like bloated and
we
gassy.
Regret it too.
Yeah.
Why did you do that?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. I make everybody miserable around me, but I'm like, I don't care. I love them so much.
But it also pairs with roasted lamb. You don't want to have too many deviled eggs.
We're gonna eat this or drink this tomorrow.
Oh, are we?
Yeah. So roasted lamb is one of my favorite things. We actually raise our own lambs and slaughter them. We've got Dorpers from High Cross Vineyards. Those guys, Cam and Erica Campbell, great folks. Mm-hmm. We actually just had babies.
We
too.
Did. Huh? We have 4 sheep, and this year we had 2 little baby lambs. Mm-hmm. They're finally old enough for us to allow our dog outside with them. Mm-hmm. Dog was a little aggressive. I mean, he just wants to play, but You grab a little thing by its neck, it's not going to last long. Mm-hmm. But they're grown up enough.
What are their names? Disco?
The kids named them Hip Hop
yeah.
and Dot. Hip Hop because if you've ever seen a baby sheep, it just like just stands there and just all four legs jump off the ground. And the kids saw Hip Hop do that once and like, Hip Hop, that's its name.
We will put some pictures of Hip Hop up on the internet.
So. Yeah, we can put it on our Instagram.
Yeah, for sure. And also, guys, if you don't follow us on Instagram, Catherine is Wine Grower's Wife, IGHYETX.
If you go follow me, don't get excited that I post a lot. I posted twice today. That's like a record for me. I'm going to get better though.
Yeah.
Chris posts a lot.
So this vineyard right here, this is owned half by Andy Timmons and half by the Paddock family. Michael Paddock and his wife were amazing people. His wife is still with us, but Michael actually passed away 2 years ago rather suddenly. He was hiking Guadalupe Peak and had a heart attack and rather suddenly passed away, which is a super bummer. He was a great guy. He was a doctor in Colorado. He's actually from Brownfield, and he and his wife worked with Andy to plant that vineyard, invest in that vineyard, and they're doing a great job. That vineyard is probably where almost a quarter of our fruit comes from. That's one of our largest growing partners, and you know, we get that Petit Verdot block is one of the oldest blocks out there, and I think that this wine in particular, I wish we would bottle more of it, but that Petit Verdot is always like that wonderful tool that we use in the winery. So we'll start out with like say 50 barrels and then slowly we'll use a barrel here, a barrel there, because it's such a good blender. It helps add depth and it adds complexity to so much. And this was actually the vintage. I harvested this with Michael. They're not intimately involved in the farming or anything, Andy and his team, but this is the last lot harvested, and I remember this day picking this fruit, and Michael, we had a good harvest too. It was like 4.5 tons, and he was super ecstatic, and he was working, which he didn't usually work harvest. He woke up. We had been picking all night. We were trying to beat a storm, and we literally picked grapes for 36 hours straight. Whoa. We picked all Whoa. Like, and we usually never pick grapes during the middle of the day because they get hot. But when this big storm cell was coming in, we had to get all the fruit out, and we ended up picking. Andrew and I were there. Andrew Sides and I were there, and we ended up picking. Helping the Lost Draw team just load trucks. We were loading, I think probably like 8 trucks that night or 7 trucks that night. It was the more we'd ever done. And we just kept on going over and over. And it was like, it was like Red Bulls and Copenhagen. Everybody's just like.
Back when you had all the bad habits.
Yeah, rolling through, man, trying to make it. And anyways, Michael comes in the morning, and they had gone bird hunting, and then he worked the scale, and it was kind of that breath of fresh air, I remember, because and also I usually do no drink. I don't have anything to drink for about 30 or 40 days.
This was before you did that, though.
No, this is 2018.
This is the first year you did it.
And so that morning was when I came off of it, and like we're just finishing up this harvest, and 9 a.m. Like I was like, I'm ready for a beer, and we had Michelob Ultra. So, anyways,
Eric,
lovely story. Yeah. And he passed away a couple months later, really, really suddenly. But he was a great guy. Had a couple of kids, and you know, his wife is still involved in La Pradera. So, all right,
Eric gets some pepper on the nose. I agree with you, Eric. Rayanne asked, what kind of dog is our problem dog with the sheep? It's a German short hair pointer.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of energy. Just quick. She's all over the place. But
and we live on 9 acres.
She has learned her lesson because we've been working with her, or they're big enough. I don't really know which is the case.
She definitely knew that when she did wrong with one of the lambs. And
yeah.
I think she's kind of learned her lesson. So Anyway,
we kept her shut up in the house for weeks, which I think was more of a punishment on me than her. But
this wine is so delicious. So delicious. I get a little, like, just a touch of green olive always off this vineyard.
Yes, pearl, Teresa. It's pearl.
And I love, love, love this wine.
Mm. Mm. Yeah, this is delicious.
Yeah, yeah. And so I got to hand it to Tony, too.
Eat some of this.
Ooh, that salami.
Some of this salami with it. I think it's going to be beautiful.
All right. I think it's time. We ready to open PetNap?
Okay, so here's what we want you guys to do. I saw earlier in the comments some of you already opened it. So you can't do this with us, unfortunately.
I want to see your pictures. I want to see your videos. I want everybody to get their phone out. Whoever is the bravest or the one who's enjoyed the No Dump Saturday the most. Okay. I want you to videotape them.
No, you're the brave one, so you open it. I'm the not brave one, so I video it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Right.
You know what I'm saying.
So I'm going to video Chris doing it. I want you guys to video whoever you're with opening the PetNap. It's always fun. Hopefully yours is really cold and upright, and it will be a beautiful, smooth opening. Mm-hmm. But sometimes they're
excited,
fun. So we want to see.
But I want everybody to get a video out and take a video of their friend or their loved one,
and then put it on Instagram or Facebook or whatever. Use the hashtag wine tasting, tag William Chris Vineyards, so we can all watch it together later.
Yeah. So you can savor these.
If you're really into it. Kelsey, are you going to do it right here for us?
Yeah, okay, I'll open it right here. Dude, okay. Do you think I should do it with a wine glass? I'm like kind of...
I mean, are you feeling it?
So, all right. I did this a long time ago with a wine glass.
That way, so... Okay, there. Okay.
This is your party trick. Okay.
You're so close to me, but I want them to see you. Okay. Okay.
Okay, so if you're going to do this with a wine glass...
Tell me when to push play, because this is going to be a real long video on Instagram.
We're going off script. Start. So this doesn't always work. I'll be fully...
And you really shouldn't be using really nice glasses. Yeah, I know, like, don't use your nice glasses.
We're going to try
just
it.
Just in case.
Yeah, oh, this is like a $35 glass.
Here we go.
Okay, so what you do...
No, I'm going to stop.
You can either... If you're going to open it, you grab a wine key or a bottle opener. Don't mess around, okay?
Go quick.
You got to... Open it, have your glasses ready, and get ready to pour, okay?
We've got three glasses ready to pour into, just in case it's really excited and it keeps going.
Yes. Do we have two bottles? Is that other one cold?
Not cold enough, but...
Okay, so
we can show
do...
you the how to what happens when it's not cold enough.
Yeah, I'm going to open this one just regular.
Okay.
And pour it, and so everybody can see. But, and we also have a YouTube video on this.
And they got that.
You got an email, right?
So what's cool about PetNat is it's totally unfiltered, totally unfined. It's all ambient yeast or wild yeast that finishes or totally completes its fermentation. There's no filtration. It's sans sucre, which means no sulfites added. This is a totally wild wine, okay? And I will say... Let's be honest, you guys all have your computers or phones out. Think about this before you open it, because every now and then you screw it up and you don't want to have a laptop right here. So we ready? Okay. We're going to grab it, open it, and pour pretty quickly. Okay.
Oh my gosh. So smooth. Smooth and easy.
So you can see that second push. As soon as the
gets definitely excited, keeping on going.
Yeah, as soon as the sediment gets exposure to oxygen, that's when the CO2 gets released. So what's crazy, and I think this is the cool and interesting and delicious part about PetNat, is the first glass, as you can see, is crystal clear, right? Which is delicious.
I will taste test all of these.
The second glass, you get the bulk of the sediment, because it takes a little bit for the sediment to get the CO2 activated, and then all the CO2 gets released. But personally, I like the one with the sediment a little bit more. Like the second or third glass is always tends to be my favorite. This wine will stay fresh in your fridge for 2 or 3 or even 4 days. If you drink half of it, do yourself a favor, just continue drinking it. But if it's if you only take a glass out of it, don't worry about it. Like throw a cork in it all the way. Shove it in there as much as you can. This wine will stay fresh. So think about this. Pétillant Naturel was kind of one of the oldest methods of making wine in the world. So they've been making wine in the world for maybe 8,000 years, 7,000 years. And about 6,000 years ago, somebody realized like, wow, wine's really shitty, right? It's full of vinegar. And people were having to add water to it at the end of, before they drank it because it was so full of vinegar because they didn't have good ways or methods of keeping the wine fresh, right? So somewhere along the line, some guy was making wine in his pot or a lady making wine in the pot or the clay pot or whatever, and or a jar, and realized, hey, if I cover this with animal skin or whatever, that will have captured the stars. They didn't know what bubbles were back then, right? But they realized that, oh my gosh, that the wine tastes better longer. And they didn't know what CO2 was, right? But the CO2 is a great, a wonderful natural preservative. And that CO2 is created, by the sugar being eaten by the yeast. And the byproduct is alcohol, heat, CO2, a number of different esters and aromas. So what we do is we pick these grapes, we make rosé, and then right before it's finished fermenting, we bottle it with a crown cap, right? And we let this wine age on its side for, in this case, almost a year. Right. And then we release it to our fans. And so that fermentation happens inside the bottle, which is what is such a cool thing about wine. Right.
That's the cool part.
That this wine was totally different 6 months ago. Yeah. And this wine is aging over its own lees or aging over its own proteins, which I find incredibly fascinating. And so if you're a PetNat fan, you'll be able to enjoy this. Every week, it's going to change a little bit, right? Because it's aging, again, over its own proteins. And that's what makes this wine interesting to me. Personally, there's a lot of crappy PetNat out there. But there's some that are really, really delicious. Josh, old winemaker, he and I actually tasted a PetNat from Ray Wilson. If you haven't been out to... Wine for the People, I highly recommend it. She's doing a great job. She has her own production thing going on and her own wines. But she used to be a wine buyer many years ago and used to work at William Chris. She helped us when we first opened. Kelsey, I see you have a question. Give me 1 second. We'll get there. Anyways, I came off of work one time. I was super tired. We had been crushing. And I got home. And I used to pay Ray ask Ray to procure us a case of wine about every month or every quarter.
Yeah.
And like, just give us a case of the weirdest shit going on in the world. Like whatever's cool, whatever's interesting. Like I want to, and she was running a really cool wine program at the time. So she had given us this bottle of PetNat and I didn't even know what PetNat was. And I was exhausted, took a shower. Catherine was like, it was probably 11 o'clock at night. I was like, babe, I just want to sit on the couch and watch a movie and, you know, watch a movie and drink some wine. And so she said, okay. And imagine it was dark. You taste this wine and you're like, it's yeasty and floral and delicious. I was like flipping online. I'm like, what is this? What are we drinking? And she's like, I have no idea.
I just grabbed something.
Yeah. And we started, and I called Ray like 11:30 at night. And I was like, what the hell is PetNat or Pétillant Naturel? And she's like, Chris, you're killing me. Nobody knows about this. We were the first people in Texas to make PetNat, and now there's multiple companies making PetNat. It's kind of like hippie champagne. So this is like the prequel to what the champagne method is. But needless to say, I absolutely love it. We drink this at our house
a lot.
Quite a bit, and it's super fresh and delicious.
I like to cheers with the sparkling. I mean, I like to cheers all the time, but sparkling wine, I feel like you have to cheers.
So, we're probably going to open one of these up. And we are almost sold out. And yeah, tomorrow. And we're almost sold out. And the 2020, well, the 2019 is drinking pretty damn delicious right now. So this is mostly Sangiovese, a little bit of Trebbiano
Toscano.
That's what
they want to know. That's what Kelsey was.
Oh, is that the question?
Say. Yeah, they want to know what.
Cool.
Grapes.
Yeah, Trebbiano Toscano, Mourvèdre, Cinsault, Sangiovese. So Sangiovese dominated, and this is mostly out of Alta Loma vineyards. The Mourvèdre is from La Pradera vineyards, Farmhouse vineyards. What we do is saignée, so it means in the middle of the night, we'll go and pull juice out of the bins. We'll machine harvest the grapes, and then immediately after, as soon as we dump in the bins, we'll go and drain the juice out, and then keep this wine really, really fresh. And I don't know, it's an evolution, and our pet nat changes every vintage very much.
There have definitely been people that said this year's is not as explosive. Their words, not mine. As other years.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, yeah, every year it's different.
Yeah, 17.
Like people have been saying hippie champagne, like it's different every year. It's out of your hands. Once it's in the bottle,
right?
That's it.
The 17 and 18, the 17 was pretty explosive.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of that has to do with production method. We're kind of like dialing in a little bit more. We're kind of changing our methodology to get it a little cleaner every year. And then we're also bottling it with a little less residual sugar, which will create a little less explosiveness.
Gabe wants us to shambong. Sorry, Gabe. We don't have any shambongs.
So if you've never seen a shambong, we actually have shambonged.
Not with us today.
Yeah, but we have shambonged on our virtual tasting.
We have shambonged on the virtual tasting. Speaking of nothing, really. Not speaking of anything, but everyone's itching for our giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
So what I think we should do is I think we should do the giveaway. And as soon as we say who it is, open that other bottle of Pet Nat.
Ooh,
as a celebration for
I love it. But before we do the giveaway,
okay.
I want to, first of all, I want to see your videos personally. So
I'll be posting mine and hopefully both of mine. I'm going to take a second one here in a minute.
Yeah.
After we're finished. So yeah. Hopefully you guys will too.
But we are about to celebrate. Sorry, that's great.
I mean, no, you got me excited.
We're about to celebrate our 11th.
You do 10, I'll do one.
11th anniversary.
We're so stupid.
11th anniversary of the bank not coming to take our stuff. It's awesome. 11 years.
11 years we've been open for the tasting room. We're not subtracting the COVID time. That just doesn't count.
F that, yeah. No. We were open.
You were here for our virtual open tasting.
Yes.
So we were
We were still business. Yeah. So even though we started our company in 2008, we call our anniversary the opening day of the tasting room in 2010. So 11 years, if you can believe it, you guys have been with us, which I'm so eternally grateful for. 11 years and
the coolest thing is, I think the coolest thing, and if my memory serves me correctly. The tasting is going to be on April 24th, and that is the actual day we opened, April 24th.
Yep. So we're going to have, we're going to pull out all the stops, do tons of cool stuff.
It's going to be good.
That is, we now have 105 members on our team, 105 families that is in William Chris
Wine. And we
Company.
Started with
one.
Chris, William, Carol, me, very part-time.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, kind of crazy. So, yeah, pretty wild. And I'm so proud that we're still here 11 years. And I'm so proud of what we've been able to build, the kind of wines that we're able to make and grow. And look at where the industry has been. Look at where we, and I'm not saying that we're the major factor in the industry, but look at what our company has been able to do as far as being a real spoke in the wheel of progress. You know, there's been some wineries around for 20 years and you know, in 30 years and look where the industry went, and then look at 10 years ago and where the industry has come in the last 5 years, especially.
We're pretty proud that we could be
absolutely
a piece.
Look at all the other great wineries coming in. Catherine and I were just at Adega Vino. If you haven't been over there, they do a great
people
job.
People were commenting about it earlier. Someone went because we mentioned it last
time.
Oh,
good.
Loved it. So yes, if you haven't been yet, definitely check it out on your next.
Our friends down the road at Sandy Road Vineyards are doing a great job. French Connection, Ben Calais.
There's so many.
It's so cool to see so many great wineries. And you know what? Today, going back to Lewis Wines was. Like we've been a wine club member there for probably like 7-8 years. Doug's been
since close to their beginning.
Yeah, Doug and Duncan have been just amazing. I mean, they're Uncle Doug to our kids, and have been for years. And Doug goes skiing with us, all the time.
We'll be going to Abastra soon. They just started a like dinner meal thing. We're gonna try that out for the first time. Super excited.
There's so much cool stuff going on in the hill country, and I know that. You know, we've been at it long, and I feel like really confident in our wines and where we're going. But man, there's so many new guys coming onto the scene. They're doing some cool stuff. And make sure you always stop at William Chris.
We got totally sidetracked. Yeah. Let's talk about what we're going to be drinking for our 11 year anniversary.
You got me all
tasting.
Hopped up on Pet Nat, and I just like got
it. You barely. Oh no, never mind. You.
No, I drank all that one.
I like the third pour. I don't know if you guys had as many glasses as us. I like the third glass. Anyway, what we're going to be tasting next, not next month. It's just what, 3 short weeks away.
Yeah, April 24th. I want everybody to get their phone out too. Get your phone out because this is important because we've got a really cool little gift for all of you today.
The first 100 people to purchase this pack to taste along with us on April 24th. Those 100 people will be receiving a
piece of paper
and a custom bamboo William Chris cutting board / cheese board, whatever you want to use it for, and the piece of paper that Chris
mentioned.
You
know what I want to use it for?
Oh my gosh.
A paddle board.
All right. You're also going to get this piece of paper Chris mentioned. That's a cheese pairing guide stop. For all the packs.
You like it a little bit though, right?
Thank God. This is I guess it's not a family show because it's about wine, but come on.
All right. No, this pairing pack though is really cool. This is everything that you need to make your own. Let's see if I can see here.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah. So yeah. Your own guide, thank you, Chelsea. And then this is a little tasting note pairing thing that will come with it. But this bamboo board is pretty cool.
Sarah calls it a custom spanking board.
That's right.
All right, Sarah.
You can.
That sounds like you're like my husband.
You can spank your wife or your husband or your kids with it. It's good quality bamboo. It's very, very hard.
It's very hard.
Sorry.
Okay.
All right.
Anyway,
so,
back to the next virtual tasting. Thank you. Kelsey is like, let me get you back on track with some graphics.
What kind of wine comes with that?
Okay, so we are going to be totally, thoroughly enjoying the 2020 Cinsault Rosé.
Oh, if you have not had this, by the way, this is 100% from La Pradera Vineyards. This Cinsault Rosé is awesome.
Yeah.
We have crushed quite a bit of this already.
If you love that Petit Verdot, it'll be so fun to taste this. Same vineyard, different vintage, of course, different grape, of course. Different style, of course, but same vineyard, so it's really neat to compare.
And then we've got the 2016 Enchanté. This is all from Bell Mountain, AVA, Granite Hill Vineyards, Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Petit Verdot. I cannot believe we're even putting this bottle of wine in this pack, but we
16.
Do it all.
Oh my gosh.
We do it all for the fans. That's a 5-year-old bottle of wine, guys. And then 2017 Tempranillo Lost Draw Vineyards. I'm pretty
My
sure
favorite.
This only went out to the Case Club. So this bottle of wine, or this vineyard, was only, it was the first High Plains grape that I ever made. And it was my first winemaking job, not here, back in the day. I made La Straw Tempranillo, and this is the first vintage I got it back. So I made 2007 Tempranillo from this vineyard, and then got to come back and make it again in 2017, which is super awesome.
Yeah, I made it
2007, 2008, and then but that was for a different winery. So, yeah. And then
last
coming up,
but not least,
this is the last vintage of 2000. Or actually, no, this is the second last vintage of 2017 Merlot 500 block.
2017 was the second to last vintage of the Merlot from Granite Hill 500.
Incredible block. Juice. Probably one of my favorite vintages ever from that vineyard.
If you've been a fan for 11 years or a good part of that, you know Granite Hill 500 block Merlot. You know how good it's been over the years. You were sad to see it go, as we all were. So it's pretty special.
I want to point out that this is like easily $200 on if you're buying this retail at a library.
It'd be way more than that.
Yeah, but this is our 11th year anniversary. That's pretty incredible.
I wonder how loud that is on the other side of this.
Sorry for yelling. Inside voice. Okay. No, seriously, 11 years, and you know what? I'll pound my chest because I'm so freaking proud of this company and what we've accomplished. And I'm so grateful to have amazing partners like Bill Blackman and Andrew Sides. Of course, all of our original founders too. It's pretty incredible to see what we've been able to accomplish. 105 families make their living growing and sharing William
just
Chris
in wine. Just 11 years, you forgot a super important point. So yes. This pack, $150, but if you use the discount code WCV11.
Why is it WCV11?
Because it's 11 years.
Congratulations, you get
okay,
a paddle.
Then you would get, oh my gosh. So then it's only $130 and $20. So that's $20 off with the discount code.
Guys, she loves it. Look.
And if you want to get shipping included and get a better deal, just add two more bottles. Grab two things you love from today.
Oh, yeah.
Two of your all-time favorites. Anything. Any two extra bottles will get shipping on us.
So, guys, go out, get this pack. Tell your friends. Have a party.
We'll be having a party.
You can order multiple ones of these, by the way, which we should actually not allow people to do that, but anyways, that's a secret for everybody.
Loophole.
Before we end this, I just want
to
say
to do a giveaway.
Yes, we have a giveaway, and I also want to say how grateful that Catherine and I are. I hope you guys know, I think we have the best job in the world. Like, I really mean that. We get to make such a difference in people's lives, and we're so grateful for all our fans out there and what you guys do. You guys make it to where we want to come to work every day and work so hard for 105 families and make their lives better and change Texas wine and keep pushing the bar up. It's incredibly meaningful for us, and know that we could not do it without you. Like, you guys make the difference. We could do all these great things, and unless we had amazing fans, then this would all be for naught. So, guys, thank you so very much. We appreciate that you do know where your wine comes from. You do know where your investments in our products go to, and it just means the world to us. So thank you. Thank you very much. All right, Kelsey, you ready?
Okay, I'm going to get ready with the camera. Where's the next pet?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
I'm
yeah.
I'm going to do this second bottle of pet nat.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. God, I forgot I committed to this.
You committed. I'm going to take another video. It's going to be...
All right, I could break this bottle or break the glass, but we'll see. So if you're going to do this parlor trick, you want to look to see where the seam is on the glass. So a glass bottle is put together by two molds, right? And so you can see this little seam. And You should use preferably a shitty glass. This is one of the best glasses in the world. It's a Gabriel glass.
Are you about to do it? I need to push start.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you're gonna knock, if you're gonna saber this off, right, with a wine glass, and again, I'm gonna preface this whole thing, which with a nice glass, it's a little bit tougher. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. We're gonna see what happens here. So celebrate 11 years.
Wait, I thought you were gonna say the name first.
Oh yeah, what's the name?
Who's our winner?
Doug Chester! Woo! Congratulations. That actually totally blew off all the way to the other side of the wall.
Wow, you heard it hit the wall.
Whoa.
I'm glad I didn't stop the recording. Here. I am so glad I didn't stop recording when I thought it was over.
Whoa, that's gonna be a good video. So, cheers. So, guys, that's how you do it. It's just it's like a putt. It's like a putter. You just putt it. You know? So, yeah, if you want to savor a wine bottle with a wine glass, that's how you do it. You see that beautiful, clean cut? That's perfection right there. Shut your mouth, Kate. Kelsey. I'm just kidding. All right.
Oh, my god.
It is a little uneven.
Everybody loves it. Wow, impressive. That was awesome. Super cool.
All right. Well, guys, this concludes our tasting. We got wine everywhere. Yes. It's our 11th anniversary.
Next time. We've
been paddled. We've been drinking. Shit got real for a little bit. I cannot thank you enough.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for sticking with us. It's kind of a long one.
Yeah, I appreciate you very, very much. And we'll check in with you soon.
See you soon.
Thank you.